Hello everyone, welcome to iExamB. There is a great news, 2019 notification of NABARD grade A and also of grade B has finally come. The notification on the NABARD website will come on 10th of May. And this is a confirmed news, so don't waste time in finding the source of it, rather focus on the preparation. The good news is here, there are grade B vacancies also, 8 vacancies at grade B level. And grade B in NABARD, RBI are at the same salary and perks level. So you are getting an excellent opportunity to make one of the highest paid career in the public sector. And at grade A level, there are 79 vacancies. The details regarding eligibility, age, the selection procedures, date, etc. will be available on 10th of May. And you will help to apply online on the NABARD website. This is an advertisement published in the newspaper, but the news is confirmed by the NABARD. Now for you, the more important aspect is how to prepare for the exam. So briefly, in this video, I am going to tell you how to prepare for phase 1, phase 2 and what are the important books. In phase 1, in addition to reasoning, English, quant and general awareness, you have computer knowledge, economics and social issues and agriculture and rural development, of course with focus with the rural India, because NABARD is working for rural India. And the number of questions also in ESI and in ARD, agriculture and rural development, are higher, and also in English. So this 200 marks paper, 200 questions in 2 hours is your preliminary exam, and this is the pattern based on the last. The final selection depends on your phase 2 score, which has paper 1. You have to write descriptive English, but you have to write using the keyboard. This is 100 marks, and paper 2 is also 100 marks, which is of economic social issues and agriculture and rural development. So you can understand the role of ESI and ARD in the NABARD. It is there in both phase 1 and phase 2. But at the same time, you have to have a good grip on quant, reasoning, English and general awareness. And then there is third phase interview, which is of 25 marks. And if you feel that you may miss this golden opportunity and the time is limited, you have this excellent course for NABARD at iExamB, which comprises of videos followed by the summary notes, practice questions, mock test, sectional test and also mock test for descriptive English. And the uniqueness of iExamB course is the live sessions in which you can ask anything to the faculty. I am telling you the cutoff last year, it will help you in understanding the competition. So that 200 marks exam on journal side, the cutoff in the prelims last year was 116 marks. And for rest of the categories, you can check it here. Likewise, the sectional cutoff in prelims, you can check here by pausing the video and you see noted down that ESI and agriculture and rural development, out of 40 marks, the cutoff was really low, 5.75 and 4 marks. In English, it was higher, 40 marks out of 40, 13.25. General awareness was very, very low, 2 marks out of 20. So the overall cutoff was higher, but sectional cutoff was low. So you have to ensure that you get marks in some of the sections so that you clear phase 1. And also see 2017, it was also 109 marks. So say 18, it increased, that shows you the increasing competition. And see the mains cutoff for 2018. It is 124 marks out of that 200, English descriptive one paper, ESI and ARD another paper. And also please note it down, this does not mean a selection, because this was the cutoff for reaching to the interview stage. Now coming to how to prepare. So for economics and social issues, the important topics are, you have to understand well about the Indian economy, special focus on the rural sector, agriculture sector. And you have to understand important issues like inflation, but unlike in RBI, don't go too much deep into inflation, but spend time in programs like poverty alleviation, employment generation, because in NABARD, the focus is always on development, rural development and agricultural development. The topics like development related topics, population trends is important. Agriculture, this you have to go in deep, important characteristics, important institutions, performance, food security. Here you need not to be very technical in knowledge. It is not that you have to understand all the crop, pest, diseases, their remedies, etc. But the data related to agriculture is very important, and also important things related to rural economy. And focus on rural credit, rural finance, financial inclusion, microfinance, rural financial institutions, because most of the questions will be asked on that. At the same time, you have to understand in general about the industry, but again, here you can be limited in your studies. The syllabus also has globalization, WTO, IMF, World Trade, etc. So, major issues you shall be aware on social structures in India. The syllabus is huge, but restrict your studies mainly to the current development, all important government schemes, understand current economic and social issues. Likewise, in agriculture and rural development, the focus is understanding the Indian agriculture well. So, this syllabus is actually huge. If you are going to read everything about agronomy, agroclimatic zone, cropping system, problems of dry land agriculture, about seed processing, meteorology, precision farming, organic farming, then soil conservation, water resources, it will be endless. So, you have to be selective in your studies based on the questions asked in the previous years, and also realizing, understanding what which any graduate can understand, because the competition is not only for agriculture graduates but for all. The syllabus also includes farm and agriculture engineering, plantation and horticulture, and also on animal husbandry, which itself is a big subject, including your poultry, fisheries, and likewise forestry. The forest reports of last years are very important. Questions have been asked on that, and also on agriculture extension program, KVKs, etc. Ecology and climate change, these are always in discussions, especially what are the things happening at international level, climate change, agreements, impact, data related to agriculture institutions, state of agriculture, Panchayati Raj institutions, and that covers actually a whole lot. Now, I am suggesting you some of the books, but you have to be very, very selective in studying from these books. Rather than reading the name, you can pause the video here, and these will help you mainly for some part of ESI and majorly in agriculture and rural development. But in books, data also will be obsolete, that you have to read from the current publications. At iExamB, we have team of expert faculty who have done post-graduations in agriculture-related subject, and also for phase 1, we have expert of quant, reasoning, English and general awareness. In addition to recorded videos and notes and practice questions for exam, you get an opportunity to directly ask your any questions to all these faculty members. You want to experience the demo course? The link to the free demo course is given in the description below. If you have any query, any question, feel free to ask in the comment section. This is a golden opportunity for you. Prepare well for the exam and get the success.